Worshipful Master, distinguished guests, brethren, all. It is indeed my honor and pleasure to have this opportunity to propose what we consider the most important toast of the evening, the toast to our visitors. Tonight, as in past installations, we have quite a number of visitors, not just from the four existing constitutions here in New Zealand, but also we have some visitors from overseas lodge. From the Lodge of Fiji, represented here by Worshipful Brother Yangona and Brother Mahara, and also from the Grand Lodge of the Philippines, Worshipful Brother Tony Jesus and Worshipful Brother John Mendoza. Please give them a hand. So to our visitors, I'd like to thank you all for coming here tonight, for gracing this occasion with your presence, and for helping us celebrate this auspicious occasion, the installation of our 147th Worshipful Master, Worshipful Brother Anand Nair, the first Mason from Fiji to assume the chairmanship, the mastership of the Prince of Wales Lodge. Brethren, as you all know, the Prince of Wales Lodge is known to be the
Premier Lodge in New Zealand.
And you know why? Because we have many engineers in our lodge. More than half of our members are engineers. And I remember the words of Worshipful Brother Fricker, but he's not here yet. Worshipful Brother Fricker in his installation at the Rodney Lodge said that the word genius was derived from the word engineer. That's why we have this word ingenious. And Worshipful Brother Fricker, of course, as you know, he's a professor in engineering, so he must be right. Engineers are in high demand, not just in this life, but also in the afterlife. Why do I say that? A friend of mine the other day told me that about this Mason who, engineer who died and reported to the gates of heaven. He was met by St. Peter's, and St. Peter asked, look at his list and say, ah, an engineer, you don't belong here, you belong to hell. The poor engineer had no choice but to report to the gates of hell, where he was welcomed with open arms by Satan. And after a while, the engineer became very dissatisfied with the level of comfort in hell. So he decided to, like a true engineer, decided to build and design and build improvements. Soon hell had flush toilets, air conditioning, and escalators. And the engineer became very popular. One day, God formed Satan. Satan, how's it going in hell? Satan said, actually, not too bad. Since you sent out that engineer, we have flush toilets, air conditioning, and escalators. You never know what that engineer will come up with next. God was surprised. What, you have an engineer? Send him back here. That must be a mistake. Satan said, no, we like an engineer in our team. God was furious. You better send him back here, otherwise I'll sue you. Satan said, really? Where do you think you'll find your lawyer? sorry, brother. You're an exception.
Harsh but true.
The moral of the story, brethren, is that if you want your locks of flourish, find more engineers. To all our visitors, thank you again for coming here tonight. I hope you have enjoyed yourself, and I hope that you will come back and visit us again. Brethren of the Prince of Wales Lodge, would you please rise? and drink a bumper toast to our visitors.
To our visitors.
Cheers.